NBA Finals come down to a decisive.
It's been a long time. It's been a long time coming.
As Coach Bo says, it's all about focus. Don't get blinded by the bright lights. Just keep your head down and work. You ready?
The long.
Welcome to Game 7 of the NBA Finals here at the American Airlines Arena in beautiful Miami. Tonight, it's all or nothing as the Oklahoma City Thunder look to win it all on the Heat's home court.
And this is a matchup, Kevin, I never tire of watching. When you talk about the elite players in the game, arguably the two leading elite players, Kevin Durant and LeBron James.
You're right, Clark. The best of the best. Top tier skill and physicality in a league of their own.
Yeah, Kevin Durant, a lifelong frame. Nobody else combines height and quickness like he does. And for LeBron, it's the combination of size, strength, and lightning speed. It's always special to see these two in action.
Now the opening lineup for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Backcourt is Westbrook and Cephalosha. Ake at the four with Perkins at the pivot. And it's Durant in at the three. And for the Heat, at the forward spots, James and Hazel. Chalmers and D-Wade are the guards. And it's Bosh in at the five, down low.
And what a terrific matchup. I mean, arguably the two best players in the game, LeBron James and Kevin Durant.
And you look at LeBron and KD, both of them small forwards in name only.
Yeah, I don't care what you call them. They're fantastic players, both tremendously skilled at their size. And great players like them really kind of make the game what it is today.
Positionless players, as Eric Spoelstra would say.
That's right.
Miami on defense to come into this one after winning on Tuesday.
I thought the way they attacked the rim and got into the paint was phenomenal. It seemed like after a while, the defense just kind of waved the white flag.
That's exactly what will happen when a team continues to attack the goal and come away with layups. It demoralizes the defense.
Now the pass to Hazel. LeBron outside. Bosh kicks to Hazel. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. And again, LeBron missing.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Durant attacking. Gets it to go.
Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Here's LeBron. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
You know, guys, I would call that methodical but explosive. You know, he waits for the opportunity, and then boom, right to the right.
Durant with it. Now defended by Hazel. No good from Durant.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions there.
I'll tell you what, LeBron can absolutely soar in for the finish. I remember last year, the alley-oop in the conference finals against Indiana just almost put his head on the rim.
Air Freight is a nickname we could dub LeBron James. I mean, he's an unstoppable force and an immovable object. Defensively, the strength, length, mobility. He can wall you up and lock you down and put you away.
Well, it's been a great series. These two teams facing off in the 2012 finals. And, of course, that series only went five games.
Now, here's Chalmers. Wade passes to LeBron. Free throw line jump shot, and he drops that one in. LeBron's got 11 points.
They're in the position they're in right now, thanks in no small part to the show that he's putting on in this period.
The Heat rebound. Back to jump. Oh, LeBron is down, and he's holding his ankle. This does not look good.
What?
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the fourth quarter here in Game 7 of the NBA Finals. We just received word that despite his severely sprained ankle, LeBron James is going to give it a go here in the fourth.
Well, Kevin, you knew if there was any way he could play at all, he was going to try to do it. And in this no-tomorrow scenario, not surprising.
Well, the question is, Clark, how much will that ankle limit what he's able to do on the court? Can he help them find a way to win it all?
And, you know, coming back to play on a high ankle sprain, that's a risk. There's not that same stability in the joint, and you can make it much worse.
And Oklahoma City, look at who they've got to strike the fourth quarter. Ran outside at the three with Ibaka playing the power forward. Cephalosha is out there with Reggie Jackson. And it's Perkins in at the center position. Knocked away. Wade kicks to LeBron. Big shot, and LeBron willing them on.
I don't know who was supposed to be on him there, but clearly a mistake by the defense.
The Thunder leading by 13. And they double up Jackson. And stolen by LeBron. And here we go. Fast break. LeBron's got it. And it's Wade with the jam.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They sure are. That's three straight buckets that have come off of assists.
And for LeBron playing with that bad ankle sprain, only something you do out of desperation.
Well, it's game seven of the finals, and he's got to take his chances here.
Cephalosha dishes to Perkins. Outside for Jackson. Just five on the clock. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. Here's Cephalosha. And nothing is falling for him right now. The Heat trail by nine. Anderson a screen on a buck. And it's Wade penetrating. Here's LeBron. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Wade's got his seventh assist in the game. Thunder shooting has been great, up over 50%. In fact, 52%. And stolen by LeBron. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And the Thunder with some changes. Udonis Haslam, he's checked in for Anderson. And it's Chalmers in for Shane Batty. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Westbrook with it. He's picked up by LeBron. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
Yeah, he's seen enough of this interior scoring that his defense is giving up. So the message during this timeout is to lock things up inside.
You know, sometimes a group can just get spaced out on defense. They're not connected and playing five as one. And usually a timeout can help you refocus and recalibrate that defense.
You know, he understandably doesn't like what's going on out there, and that's why he wants to talk things over during this timeout.
I think this is a good time to call a timeout. They just need to hit pause for a second and then reset as well.
Chris Anderson has checked in for Miami. Hattier comes in for Mario Chalmers. The Heat trail by four. LeBron James on the wing. From outside, off the mark.
You know, even though he missed that three-point shot, I think the defense has to do a better job of challenging the shot.
Yeah, because you know if you continue to give up open looks like that, you're in big trouble. LeBron finding a way to provide what little he can out there.
And that one's good.
And his shots are dropping right now. This quarter has been very kind to him.
A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. They double him with LeBron. And LeBron, pardon, just at himself right now, not even close.
Yeah, but LeBron at 50% is better than a lot of players at their best, quite honestly. We'll see how he holds up, though. Boy, it's been a tough go in terms of fouls for him. And my goodness, he can't stay out of the way of fouls. An excellent game we've seen from LeBron. He has 20 points, and the steals are starting to pile up for him also.
They sure have, and clearly he's gotten in their heads because of it, Clark. You guys are looking over their shoulder now, always worrying about where he is.
He's certainly been hitting well from the line, and those points do add up.
It's stolen by Wade to take the lead, and goaltending is going to be the call, so they get the basket there anyway.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Cephalosia passes to Westbrook. Out to Ibaka. Got a piece of it. Stolen by Wade. Leads him in there. Offensive rebound. And the rejection by Cephalosia. And again, it's LeBron James. LeBron's got 26 points.
Wow, having a hard time creating space for his shot. He's still hitting, even with a hand in his face.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. And during this timeout, I'm sure they'll be hydrating themselves with Gatorade. All the effort out there on the floor. And these timeouts can be such a huge factor in getting a short rest and recharging the battery. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter.
Seems to me that anytime the game is on the line, I mean, he's perfectly willing to be the hero or the GOAT for that matter. And that's what it takes to be clutch in big situations. You can't be afraid to fail.
And something else he does is he's great off the dribble. He can take it to the rack or pull up. So as a defender, you don't know how to play him.
They double him with LeBron. Thunder trailing by 4. Westbrook with it. Wade picks him up. Durant kicks to Ibaka. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Ibaka playing well. He has 8 points and also a blocked shot.
And a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Heat.
Well, it's been an outstanding game for them in the open court. Their fast break points really stand out.
The other thing they're doing, guys, is forcing turnovers and then creating points offensively as a result.
The Thunder have gone 1-4 since the end of the third quarter. And stolen by LeBron. And LeBron not just battling through, but finding the lift to dunk it down.
Boy, the kind of moments you love to see. Excellent defense leading to a dunk at the other end.
Clark, you got to marvel at the transition game when they've got it clicking. It's really explosive.
High octane for sure.
Oof. And turning defensive pressure into offensive opportunities. That's what it's all about.
Anderson, good, and the assist goes to LeBron. LeBron's got 3 assists tonight.
And they got exactly what they wanted right there. Really high percentage look.
Westbrook kicks to Cephalosia. Sinks the triple.
Well, that's just one make for him in the fourth. I mean, he just hasn't been able to do it for him scoring-wise.
It's LeBron with the drive. Gets it to go. LeBron's got 32 points in the game.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
Bosch kicks to LeBron. The fast break ends at the rim with a jam.
Boy, their defense making an impact here late, Kevin.
And straight off the steal, Clark, a perfectly run fast break ends in a slam dunk.
That could be a huge 4-point swing in this game.
And it's Durant missing.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
And it's out of bounds to the Heat as Miami retains possession. And some changes here for the Heat. Udonis Haslam, he's checked in for Anderson. And it's Chalmers in for Shane Battier. Westbrook with the steal.
Watch outside.
Cephalosia with it. And it's off from 3-point range. LeBron outside. It's good, only a few seconds into the shot clock. LeBron's got 36.
Just look at how quickly their lead has grown over the course of the last few possessions.
Boy, they've really saved their best for last, haven't they?
Westbrook, no good.
You see the defenders get out of his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the bucket, but not that time.
LeBron outside, a second chance effort, and that one's good. LeBron's got 38 points.
And the fans loving what's transpired here tonight. A really good victory for these guys.
Sure was. I mean, they did just what they needed to do to keep the visitors from getting any momentum going at all.
Here's Cephalosia. Offensive struggles continue, missing again. Timeout called, the Heat. They're in front by 12. 1 second left to play here in the fourth. Guys, what do you think?
Well, they're obviously going to win, but this timeout may be about some substitutions.
Well, they may just want to make sure they don't do anything really foolish at the very end here.